The early recordings were pretty bad, by modern standards, I guess. But it's the only way, when you think about it, that you can listen back and hear music talking that was happening around the turn of the century.
Peter Tolmachov was bitten by the nostalgia bug when he was just 11 years old. He got his first Edison phonograph on his 12th birthday. He grew up to become an electrical engineer and is now working toward a medical degree in San Diego. But the first 50 years of recorded sound, which he describes as from tin foil to the talkies, still fascinates him.
If nothing else, I think it gives you a good perspective on history, the history, let's say, of the last this last century. And I don't think there's any harm in that. It's kind of a time machine. It's kind of a way of looking back on history, the same way we all like to look at old movies. But so rarely, compared to movies, do we get a chance to hear things that were going on. And let's say hear music the way it really was played, the way it was really orchestrated, and hear popular songs about events that were happening at the time, like the First World War, Prohibition, and things like that.
Today, Tolmachov has a dozen early model phonographs, 250 cylinders, and 1,000 early shellac discs. One of his favorite recordings is President Roosevelt defending the farmer. Teddy Roosevelt, that is.
It is well to have our cities prosper, but it is not well if they prosper at the expense of the country.
Well, there's, of course, that aspect of being able to look back on something that happened so long ago. And I don't know, something just kind of snapped in me when I started with it.
The machines can record as well as play back, and Peter Tolmachov can create his own nostalgia. From the Unicorn Theater in La Jolla,
Not another record reporting. 14